my panel. It's 12208 three-phase panel, fed by this guy and that guy right there. We're gonna walk over. I'm gonna make sure I have power on my plug, which I should, but I'm gonna plug my leads into the plug, which I already have done, so I can see it. Walk over here. Alright, boom, I have power. Wait, and these are the plugs I'm changing. I'm gonna change the ones with the orange tape on them and that guy with the yellow tape on them, and I think that one right there as well. So, we have power on them. We know that. We're gonna walk back, flip the breaker we think it is, because things aren't very properly labeled in here, which is one of the things I'm fixing, as well as the plugs. We're changing to a more standard configuration, L1820 by Legrand. So I'm gonna assume the ones with the orange tape were the one with the orange tape here. Boom, off. All right, let's go check our tester now, see what we got. Ooh, we have no power, but I'm gonna go double check that. All right, see, nothing on the tester. Nothing there, so we're dead. Now I'll make sure to check the other one, the other plug, before I take it apart. So now I gotta walk back to the panel. Seems kind of redundant, but it's a lot easier to do with two people, you know, walking back and forth between where I'm working and where the panel is. And now I'm just gonna lock out, take out this breaker so that nobody can turn it on. So I will show you how to do that. All right, so we do lockout tego to ensure safety when we're working on the equipment, because a lot, in this big company that I'm working at, the panels are very far apart from where I'll actually be working, so I don't want anyone to come in behind me and start like turning on breakers that I'm working on. So I don't want to be working with any live part. All right, guys, so this is the breaker I got turned off. That was power to my plugs. I have my lockout tego kit right here for my QO breakers. This is my lockout. I should have like a plate on here who says who took it off. I don't have those yet, so right now I don't have a tag on my actual lockout that has, you know, my name information on it, who I am, you know, so they can, my contact information, just in case they need to grab me to turn it on for any reason, really. So this just plugs on just like so. Goes on just like that. And you just clamp it on. It locks up here. So just make sure that's locked. And then the lock runs right through that. Oh. Locked up. Alright, there we go. That's how you do a simple lockout takeout. Now, again, I say we do this for like safety, making sure nobody comes on, turns this on while I'm working on the equipment. So that's how we do it. All right, guys, so here we go. I'm gonna show you how to test for power, just to make, so we already locked out everything. It's off that we know of, but we're gonna make sure, double, triple check by just making sure there's no live voltage on the lines here. So I'm gonna show you how to do that. So you can see my tester. I'm gonna use the ground pin, and then I'm gonna check each phase. All right, so I'm getting a VDC reading. That's nothing. Nothing. Now I'm gonna assume this one's the same way. Now, if I did get a live reading, it would show up AC and it would hold the voltage for me. So right now I don't have any power on either of both those plugs. So we're gonna go ahead and change those out now. All right, guys, so there you got it. We got our two cord drops changed out right here. And we changed the male ends too on the machines so that they match. Alright, so let's go pull that lockout off and we'll make sure we got our plugs labeled so that we can find these a lot easier than we did last time. Alright guys, so we got our brother P-Touch here. We're gonna come over to the panel, make sure we got our circuits and our panel labels correct. So, just gonna walk here. Open this guy up. All right, circuit 20, 22, 24 for this guy. So first I wanna make sure I have the right panel too. So this is panel L10. Panel L10, we're going to, so we got L8, so we gotta get to 10. So we got our label ready to get printed. I'm ready to pull the lockout off now. We can now pull that off. See if I can do this one-handed so I can show you guys. Up close. Maybe not. Okay. There we go. Set the lock down. There's a little tab up here. You just push it. Feel it, boom, lockout is off. And we're ready to flip it on. Well, I didn't hear anything explode, so that's probably a good sign. Now we're gonna walk over to our plugs with our labeler. And we're gonna label these guys so that we don't have to guess which plug we're turning off, because it's really important, especially in a building like this, because we run into situations where there's a lot of machines running at the same time here. So if you shut off the wrong breaker and jam up a machine, the operator and the head of management isn't going to be very happy with you for doing that. So here we go, print. These things are awesome, man. These are very legible, clear labels. I love using these. Boom. And that's what goes on our plug. Some of these are pretty long, so they wrap around the plug a pretty good amount. So I try not to cover up any of the labeling of the plug so you can tell which one it is, what kind it is. So I make sure to stay underneath it, but not enough to interfere with any of the screws that you gotta pull off or anything. So just like that. Now we know. L10. I'm gonna print another one right away. Do the same exact thing on the other one. You know, we want to make sure everything's labeled correctly now, because production is very important to this client, so making sure that we don't interrupt production as much as possible is really key to the success of this client and I. So we try to do everything we can to make sure they're good to go, and that all the machinery is kept up, good maintenance, and the electrical equipment, anything like that, cleaning out breaker panels, boxes, stuff like that. I'll have later videos showing you guys what we're doing there, because we got a ton of equipment here that we service. So all right, let's do our voltage check, make sure that the sucker's running. So I'm gonna zoom out. Let me give you guys my tester view so you can see what I'm looking for. Boom. Alright, so let's just go to ground. Start. So 120, 120, 120. It's all looking good. Let's go 208. 208. So we double checked that all the phases were properly phased. I'm gonna do the same thing actually on this guy. Just to make sure. So those are 100% ready to go, changed out. We're going to plug these into the machine now and give them a test. So let's get this plugged into here. Boom. See if we can test run some of this stuff now. Ooh, I don't know if it's gonna work without the machine running. So what we're looking for here is our, make sure our phasing's correct. I took the plugs off and put them on exactly the same way as they were, because if you change them, they'll move this equipment around, and then they'll really get upset with you when the stuff runs backwards when they move it. So right, it's really important to keep it the way they had it, because it should work almost anywhere in the building the way it is. So everything looks like it seems to be moving the right way, so that's good. All right, and then we'll move on to our next set.